tour started in France in the fall of 1917, during the last months of the First World War.
Now planes, all that filthy noise. Pretty soon it's curdled milk we'll be getting from the cow.
One of them Sam's in trouble. Something's wrong.
Sauten, wait! Sauten!
Soldiers, flyers, drink loose women, and trouble. That's all they're good for.
What do we have today, Anna?
Celery, Monsieur Gold.
Rotten apples and celery. That's the diet for a man. What am I supposed to do? Wiggle my ears and whinny?
Things could be worse. We do have some food. And this house is the only one still standing for miles around. You should thank the Lord instead of complaining.
I must admit that the house and the wine cellar have been miraculously spared. It could be the good Lord. On the other hand, it could also be Bacchus.
No, Monsieur le Comte, really, it's too early.
Quite right, Anna. No respectable man should start drinking at this hour of the day. I, on the other hand, have been drinking since quite a respectable hour last night.
Died, gone to heaven.
Oh, mon Dieu.
letter from the army telling us you're wounded and in a hospital. But they didn't tell us where you are or how hurt you are. Said it can be much better. We hope you'll recover well. Come back to us soon. We miss you. We need you. The weather has been strange. Not like other years at this time. Maybe it's not. We had a bad frost some days back, but the potatoes are safe. Blanche had a calf. It was weak. It is stronger now. We lost 2 chickens, but your pa got the fox. Pierrot has been helping. He's strong for 14. We hope you'll be back soon. There's much to be done. Love, your wife, Anne. A lovely letter, Charles. It should help you get back on your feet quickly. So you're awake at last, Captain. How do you feel?
Well, I was always told St. Peter looked after new arrivals. So who are you? A heavenly angel? St. Clair, St. Teresa.
You're being blasphemous instead of grateful. You should see what's left of your aircraft. Major Brochard, do you want to examine the English flyer? He's awake now.
Oh, wait. I'm not English. I'm South African.
Oh, and there's a difference?
As much as between their rain and our sun, manners.
This one looks very much alive and kicking. He can wait. Maybe more wounded should be brought in upon your horse. It brings about miraculous recoveries.
You. You saved me from the fire. I think I preferred your other uniform. Less spirituality, but definitely more charm.
You need cleaning up, Captain.
Michael. And what's your name, nurse?
Nurse.
Oh!
The Major is right. You're alive and kicking. Far too alive, if you ask me.
No, wait. You saved me. You can't leave me now. Well, I feel awful. I've got these shooting pains in my head. There's a... something I can't see, my eyes. I knew it. She was only a vision.
A miracle. The captain can see again.
Tell me something. That nurse friend of yours. What's she like? Well, does she have a boyfriend? Is she married?
You're referring to the daughter of the owner of this chateau. She's not a nurse. She's Comtesse Santaine de Thierry.
Santaine. What an extraordinary name.
Doc, you can open your eyes now. We've landed.
A miracle. That's what I call it. A bloody miracle.
It's me, okay? And this is the German's plane. Now, we're flying along through the clouds. And I don't know who's behind me. And suddenly, as we come out of the clouds, well, there he is, right behind me. So I spin round with the plane, so I'm behind. They're flying like this, and I
what do you know? I'm looking for a dead hero, and I find a living clown, Andrew.
Captain Courtney's flying adventures have been very useful. You see, we have neither anesthetics nor sedatives. These stories make quite a good substitute for the patients. They're very soothing.
You're very cruel to me. As a punishment, I'm going to introduce you to my notorious friend, who's also my commanding officer. This is Lord Andrew Killingarrett, and Captain Surgeon Clark. And this is Santaine, Comtesse de Thierry.
Delighted to meet you. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have to prepare his dressing.
Well, what do you think? Remember, I saw her first.
So, that's the way it is.
She's the woman of my dreams, Andrew.
Oh, really? You don't say, laddie. You South Africans are all crazy.
Yeah, it's not just your heart that's wounded.
I'm burnt all over, damn you.
Oh. We're just in time. I brought good old Doc.
And medicine.
Good Scotch whiskey. Great stuff to bring you back from the dead. And I got a whole crate full in the sidecar.
Crate, you say? Well, I know just the place to put it to good use.
Some respect. There are sick people here.
No, madame. Not exactly sick people. I see here a lot of young people. Well, most of them are missing a piece or two, granted. But they still have a lust for life. Plenty of taste for happiness. Besides, we've only used 2 bottles. The rest, we leave to you. Scotch whiskey. It's the oldest anesthetic there is.
In any event, madam, we do apologize. Now we'll be off.
Yes, yeah, it's time we go back.
Ah, bye. See you later.
Bye.
Bye.
Captain, may God protect you.
May he bless the German pilot who shot me down.
Good morning, sir. And how are we today? Scorched.
That's how we are, pigs. What time is it?
7:30, sir. Typical winter morning.
Damn, I missed the morning patrol. Oh, why didn't you wake me?
You haven't missed it, sir. You're grounded.
Grounded?
Major Killigarren's order, sir. And about time, too, it was. We've been flying for 37 days in a row. Breakfast is served, sir.
Oh. Why do I feel so awful, Biggs?
According to the Major, sir, We were knocked down by a bottle of 10-year-old Scotch malt whiskey.
It's all coming back to me now. Not before I bashed up the old yellow turtle, huh?
Spread it all over the French countryside, sir. We should be grateful. We're in one piece.
Oh, my head. What's this?
Aspirin, sir. Compliments of the Major.
I suppose he's flying this morning.
Of course. Took off at dawn as usual. The Major left you the key to his motorbike and said to give his compliments to Mademoiselle de Thierry.
Biggs, pull out my best uniform.
Yes, sir.
Shine up my eaglets.
Yes, sir.
Shine up my boots. We want to look our best, our very best, Biggs.
Are we courting, sir?
That's right, Biggs. That's exactly what we're doing. We're courting. No flaps, no stalls, full throttle.
Very well, sir.
Look, I don't care about the pain just as long as they save the leg. Just tell him not to take it off, please.
Yes, yes, of course. Don't worry, you must stay calm.
Guides. I'm young, but I know my way. Out there, it's all light and air. You should see it. I don't want to be a cripple, stuck in the valley below. Just promise me, whatever you do, don't let them amputate. Promise me!
I promise. I promise.
Good. Good. It's dark in the valley, especially in the winter. Up there, never dark, always light. It's always light.
Well,
I can do no more for now. The anesthetics arrived.
Not yet. Pussy promised the trucks would be here today.
Bureaucrat promises. We'll give it another couple of hours.
You mean you're going to amputate?
The gangrene has spread too far. It's either his leg or his life. My dear, you're exhausted. Take a break, please. We'll manage. Thank you.
Fontaine?
The crazy South African.
Michael.
Michael.
They gave me some sick leave and I wanted to see you again. Well, I thought about crashing down here in another airplane. I don't think my commanding officer would be very pleased. Besides, I'm grounded. Are you on duty?
No. I'm off duty. As of now. Come on. I'll show you the estate. It was beautiful here before this horrible war.
From here, it's as if the war had never happened.
Michael, tell me more about Africa.
I've done nothing else for the last 2 hours. I thought I was boring you.
No, I could listen to you forever. Does it ever rain down there?
Not much. But when it does, it's like the end of the world. Everything in Africa is like that. Stronger, wilder, sharper, with all the colors and smells and sun.
The sun?
Yes. The sun's not like here. Pretty and shy. It's fierce, dangerous, bold. Sunsets are gigantic battles. Fiery and dramatic. With the sun fighting to preserve every last ray of light.
For me, there's never enough sun. I hate cold and damp. Tell me more about the people. The black savages.
There's some pretty savage whites, too. And some very noble blacks. All the different tribes. The Watusi, Zulu, Ivambo, and the little Bushman too. Extraordinary people, all of them.
You love them, don't you?
Yes, I do. There's something about Africa. Makes you part of it. And once you're part of it, never lets you go. Not even when you're away. It's part of me. It's in my heart. It's my land.
I shall go to Africa.
Santé.
Yes, Michael.
country, the Bushmen believe that if you save somebody's life, you've interfered with the gods and with that which was written, fate. Therefore, you have to take their place. The life that you save then becomes your responsibility forever. And belongs to you. So you see, Santen, from now on, I belong to you.
To you, Michael. To you.
Yes. I do. Vows are missing.
And tomorrow you'll be back up there with them.
No, not tomorrow.
Well, the day after tomorrow then, or the day after that. I hate this horrible war. Sometimes I get the feeling that it will go on forever. That the only ones left will be either old or mutilated. That all the young men will be killed.
All the young men or just the brave, handsome ones?
Michael, don't you see? We may never have another chance to be together, you and I. From now on, we have to live every minute of our lives as if they were the last minutes we have. We've got to be together. No. Oh my God, evening shift. I must go. I'm already too late. This barn.
When?
Tonight, around midnight. It'll be cold. Better bring a blanket. Do you still love me?
No, I don't love you. I worship, adore, and revere you.
You impudent lout. I feel wonderful.
you something. More than life.
Michael, tell me more about Africa.
Is it me or Africa you love?
You and Africa are one to me.
And we'll go there together. We'll have lots of children. And they'll all be African.
So sudden, so unexpected.
Papa, this is love, not measles. There are no warning symptoms.
I know, but usually one has time to get adjusted, to plan, to something. I know you've been able to twist me around your little finger since you've been 5 years old. But this is serious. Are you sure?
Totally sure. I love him more than life.
It means you'll have to leave this place? Your country? Everything you know? And go to Africa, this place so far, so savage. Uncivilized.
Papa, when I see what we civilized people are doing to one another, Africa seems to be the only sane place left in the world.
That's something. Maybe if you had more time to think it over.
Papa, I love him. I want to be his wife, share his life, and I know he'll make me very happy.
Right. I give up. Well, when do I meet the fellow?
This evening. Papa, I'm so happy.
Two weeks later, Michael and I were officially engaged.
Santaine, Michael, you have all my blessings. Santaine, I swore to your dear mother on her deathbed that I would see to it that you would grow into a healthy and virtuous young woman, until a day where the worthy young gentleman would ask for your hand in marriage. And it seems that day has come, even though this young man will be taking you away so far from here.
But we want you to come with us, Papa. Isn't that so, Michael?
You must come, sir.
And you too, Anna.
I would like to see you try and stop me.
It's very generous of both of you. But an old tree like myself transplants badly. I'd never consider leaving this land. Not even German cannons have managed to uproot me. It would be a comfort knowing you're safe in a new land, a country as young as you are, something. Your head.
Something. Sun's up. I have to be going soon, otherwise I'll miss the morning patrol.
Bloody war and planes. That's all I care about.
Some truth in that, I suppose. War and planes was all I used to think about.
And Africa.
And Africa. Then I met you. And I realized there was something else.
Such as?
Delight. You're a source of perpetual delight for me.
That's very nice. I like that.
What? What's so funny?
I was just thinking, next time it'll be official and in a proper bed. Oh. Do you think it'll be as good?
Shameless, immoral hussy. That's what I'm marrying. I should go. Andrew will kill me if I'm late again.
I understand. Just as long as you're not late tomorrow.
Why? What's happening tomorrow?
It's our wedding day.
Oh, yes.
Do you feel better now?
Yes. What happened?
You mustn't tire yourself. Lie down. Lie down a bit longer.
My baby, what happened?
I'm all right, Aunt Anna.
About. What's wrong with me? My poor baby. My poor baby. What seemed to happen? You're... What? You're pregnant.
Are you sure?
Yeah. happy, Anna. I'm happy. Thank you.
So then, where are you going, child? Have you gone mad?
Yes. Mad with joy, Anna. I'm going to have a baby.
The whole world doesn't need to know.
Can you see anything yet?
I'm sure it will be a boy. You're hopeless. Completely out of your mind. A baby in this hell.
Anna, we're going to have a baby. And it'll be beautiful. And then we'll have others. Lots. And you have to help me, won't you? Because I know nothing about babies.
Anna. Oh, Anna, I'm so happy. Try the patience of the saint.
Did Mama really wear this gown on her wedding day?
Yeah, she did. But she was half the trouble and bother you are.
Oh, no, sorry. I won't. It's Michael. It's Michael! Oh.
Wait! Louis!
Bad luck to do that. The groom shouldn't see the wedding gown before the ceremony.
Don't be absurd, Louis. That's just an old superstition.
Come on, Grumpy. Brighten up. It's a beautiful day. It's the happiest day of my life. I order you to be happy.
I'm happy.
Chant. He must be mad to keep you waiting.
All in the wrist. The pouring must be steady and smooth. No jerkiness, nor violence, which would bruise the masterful work of the grape.
Sorry, mademoiselle, I can't get through. The line is dead.
What's going on?
The enemy has launched an offensive. The front line is breaking up. We have orders to get the wounded to safety as quickly as possible.
What are we going to do? Michael. What about Michael?
Come on, in the air! We're sitting ducks! In the air! We'll meet in Poland. You got that?
I must go to her!
Of your mother's potion with his rifle and his best bottle of cognac.
Listen to me and don't argue. I go get Papa. You go with him. Keep this. I'll join you later. I have to wait for Michael. I know he'll come here. You understand?
Yeah.
I stood them off at Sedan, and I stunned them off again.
Papa.
You've missed me! This one's for you!
Papa. listen to me. We've got to get you out of here before it's too late.
Jamais. I shall never leave this place. It is my land, my home. Here I loved my wife. Here I remain with her. They think I'm finished. They'll see. Just like Sedan! By God! Just like Sedan!
He won't listen to me. You try and get him out of here. I'll make sure the trucks don't leave without you. Louis. Louis. Can you hear me? Louis. My darling. My one and only love, Louis. It's me, Anna. Louis.
I wasn't late, Fontaine.
My life in France. 3 months later, I was on my way to Africa.
Something wrong. The cannon.
You're turning all black, like a peasant woman.
Gold, I'd say.
The tan is not becoming of a lady. Whoever saw a real lady who didn't have very white skin?
Anna, right now I'm a nurse, not a lady. A nurse who volunteered to go to Africa. And besides, this sun is so beautiful. Do you realize that in a few days we'll be there? Anna, I'll be able to keep my promise to Michael. His son will be born in Africa.
Not if it's a daughter.
Anna!
And not if you get sunstroke before we get there. I'm getting you a hat.
Greetings, Sister Sunshine. How are we today?
Beautiful, thanks. I'd be even happier if I could finally see a bit of land.
Well, Cape Town's only 5 days away. With God's help, and if the weather holds.
Oh, so we're already off the African coast?
We have been for days.
Were you born down there, Ernie?
Me? No, I was born in America. I went to South Africa as a settler before the Boer War. Times were tough.
There was a war in South Africa?
Ooh, indeed there was. English against the Boers.
Why?
The usual reasons for a war. Greed, pride, suspicion. See, the Boers had grabbed off the best part of South Africa, all the gold and diamonds. And they wanted to set up on their own. The hell with good old England. It wasn't easy, believe me.
Please go on.
Well, those Boers are a hard-headed lot, and some of the finest shots in the world. You're hearing that from a man who got fired at.
And what about now?
Now? Now the Boers are good subjects of the British Empire. Well, almost all of them anyway. There's still a few diehards who fight on the ground and side with the Germans. And there's no capturing them. They know the inside of Africa better than the wild animals do. Well, for instance, there's this Lothar de la Rey. Well, he's like a ghost. He strikes and vanishes. The British have never been able to get their hands on him. And God knows they've tried.
So much to learn. So much to understand.
Come on! It's good to see you, Herr Dolore. You can't imagine how good. We barely had enough fuel for another 2 days.
You had a good voyage, Captain?
126 days out. 26,000 tons of enemy fleet sunk.
Magnificent. With God's help, I hope you seem to get at least the same amount in your return voyage.
With God's help. And with yours, my dear friend. Anything of interest?
The freighter Auckland docked at Durban 2 days ago. To load coal. There are more than 2,000 New Zealand soldiers aboard. We should sail on the 15th.
2,000 soldiers? Not bad.
I've got better. My spies tell me that on the 5th, the heavy cruiser Inflexible sailed from Gibraltar. It's bound for Cape Town.
The Inflexible. Now that's a tasty morsel to give the Kaiser and our glorious Navy.
And a nice slap in the face for the proud British bastards.
Sometimes I think you hate them more than we do.
I have no illusions, Captain. Your war is one of nations. One day it will end, and so will our alliance. My war with the British is personal. It will never end.
It's her, isn't it? It's the Inflexible.
Well, the profile fits. The dimensions are those of a first-class cruiser. And the route and the position correspond to calculations.
It's got to be her. We'll never get another chance like this one. Stations 1 and 2. Torpedoes. Los.
Come on, get that boat, we're sinking.
in another boat. Come on, jump!
Dad!
For God's sake, jump in there!
Stop that!
Come on, for God's sake, get in there!
Dad!
All right, take care of her. Come on, get
Stop
in there!
Stop that!
Come on! All right, lower away!
Stop that!
Lower away!
What shall we do, sir?
Nothing. There are too many of them. And you know the orders from Berlin. We're not allowed to take any prisoners. We can't do anything. Order the men to leave their combat stations. Immersion.
I wonder if Lothar knew.
Good morning, sunshine. How's things? Easy, easy, beautiful. Or we'll all end up in the water again.
We're alone.
Yeah. We're also alive. After what happened, that's a step in the right direction.
What did happen?
What else? The Germans.
And we're all we know.
Well, I figure about 60 miles west of the African coast.
It's a lot, isn't it?
It's a fair piece. But if the current helps us and the wind, we got a chance.
Is there any water? I'm terribly thirsty.
Try not to think about it, Sunshine. It only makes things worse. Here, give me a hand. You know how to make leads? Come here, I'll show you. Here. Now, you see, you take this knife. There. Now, and you hold this here just like that and put that knife right here. Right in there. Put that little thing in through there and it looks like a little snake going around a stump. You know what I mean? Here, you try it. Here. Atta girl. Go ahead. Hey, good girl.
What is it for?
Well, I'm trying to set up a bunch of counterweights. I saw the natives do it in Hawaii. It's to keep us from capsizing all the time. But also, even if it doesn't work, keep us from thinking for a little while. Tie that knife around your waist. All we need to do is lose it overboard. There. Huh. That's better. Seasick now. What's going to happen if we hit some rough weather?
I'm not seasick.
It's probably lack of food and water.
It's not that either.
What is it?
It's morning sickness. In this case, night sickness.
You mean...
Yes. Yes. That's why we've got to make it. You understand? We've got to make it.
did something in my back. Oh. What? By my legs? I can't feel my legs.
I beg your pardon, madam, but would you be Madame Anna Stock?
Mademoiselle Stock. And who are you, may I ask?
I'm Gary Courtley, Michael's uncle. Mademoiselle Saint-Initiaire was kind enough to write to me from France to tell me what had happened and to let me know of her arrival and yours.
This is no time for formalities. Can't you see I'm done up as a stevedore?
Well, I'm so pleased. Obviously, I'm very distressed to meet you in such circumstances, not only losing my nephew in the war, but also his fiancée, my grand niece, as it were, even before meeting them.
What the devil are you talking about? Don't you dare say such things.
Oh, madam, mademoiselle, I'm so sorry. I do beg your pardon. Have I offended you?
Sartain is not dead. And don't you dare speak about her as if she were. Is that clear?
Fontaine is still alive.
But of course she's alive.
But how do you know? I mean, where is she?
That's what you and I are going to find out. We'll organize an expedition at once. We'll look for her and find her. Where are we going?
Well, my motor car. Thomas. Sunshine, look. A bird.
I've seen birds before.
Bird means we're close to land. Land. Here, sunshine. Seaweed. Grab it. It's suck on it. It's bitter, but water. It's land.
Africa.
That's Africa. Africa. Did you hear, little one? We made it. We made it. Africa. I can't believe it. Africa.
A lousy place. Nothing but sun. Barren. Desolate. Savage.
And beautiful.
Matter of taste. The main thing is, this land. Sunshine. We're carrying too much weight. If the wind stops, the current will take us away from the shore.
It doesn't matter. Another day now won't make a difference.
Another day without food and water. Bad for the baby. Centaine. Look at me. I'm the dead weight.
Ernie, don't say such things.
Look, sunshine. My days are over. No more sailing. Me end up in a wheelchair? Without my weight, you can hit shore by morning.
Ernie. We've gone this far together. We'll continue together. Yes. Now you get some rest. Rest.
Baby. Soft. Tiny. I wonder, boy or girl?
I'm
the radiator boiled over again.
My dear, the temperature is about 110 degrees Fahrenheit.
Don't you dare me. That's the third time the radiator's boiled. And we've broken five wheels. At this rate, a girl will be an old woman when we find her. Don't you agree, Lieutenant? Or do you think we're wasting our time?
After all, the sea search was abandoned. I was ordered to escort your expedition.
But
I'm sorry to say that even if the young lady made it to shore, this is an immense territory. It's full of savages and outlaws and wild animals. I'm afraid, in all honesty, it's rather hopeless.
Sorry.
Is to the south. Captain, may God protect you.
May he bless the German pilot who shot me down.
Good morning, sir. And how are we today? Scorched.
That's how we are, Biggs. What time is it?
7:30, sir. Typical winter morning.
Damn, I missed the morning patrol. Oh, why didn't you wake me?
You haven't missed it, sir. You're grounded.
Grounded?
Major Killigaren's order, sir. And about time, too, it was. You've been flying for 37 days in a row. Breakfast is served, sir.
Oh.
do I feel so awful, Biggs?
According to the Major, sir, we were knocked down by a bottle of 10-year-old Scotch malt whiskey.
It's all coming back to me now. Not before I bashed up the old yellow turtle, huh?
Spread it all over the French countryside, sir. We should be grateful. We're in one piece.
Oh, my head. What's this?
Aspirin, sir. Compliments of the Major.
I suppose he's flying this morning.
Of course. Took off at dawn as usual. The Major left you the key to his motorbike and said to give his compliments to Mademoiselle de Thierry.
Biggs, pull out my best uniform.
Yes, sir.
Shine up my eaglets.
Yes, sir.
Shine up my boots. We want to look our best, our very best, Briggs.
Are we courting, sir?
That's right, Biggs. That's exactly what we're doing. We're courting. No flaps, no stalls, full throttle.
Very well, sir.
Look, I don't care about the pain just as long as they save the leg. Just tell him not to take it off, please.
Yes, yes, of course. Don't worry, you must stay calm.
My father, my brothers, we're all guides. Guides. I'm young, but I know my way. Out there, it's all light and air. You should see it. I don't want to be a cripple, stuck in the valley below. Just promise me, whatever you do, don't let them amputate. Promise me!
I promise. I promise. I promise.
Good. Good. It's dark in the valley, especially in the winter. Up there, never dark, always light. It's always light.
Well, I can do no more for now. Well, the anesthetics arrived.
Not yet. Pussy promised the trucks would be here today.
Bureaucrat promises. We'll give it another couple of hours.
You mean you're going to amputate?
The gangrene has spread too far. It's either his leg or his life. Dear, you're exhausted. Take a break, please. We'll manage.
Thank you. Sontan?
The crazy South African.
Michael.
Michael.
They gave me some sick leave and I wanted to see you again. Well, I thought about crashing down here in another airplane. I don't think my commanding officer would be very pleased. Besides, I'm grounded. Are you on duty?
No. I'm off duty. As of now. Come on. I'll show you the estate. It was beautiful here before this horrible war.
From here, it's as if the war had never happened.
Michael, tell me more about Africa.
I've done nothing else for the last 2 hours. I thought I was boring you.
No, I could listen to you forever. Does it ever rain down there?
Not much. But when it does, well, it's like the end of the world. Everything in Africa is like that. Stronger, wilder, sharper, with all the colors and smells and sun.
The sun?
Yes. The sun's not like here. Pretty and shy. It's fierce, dangerous, bold. Sunsets are gigantic battles. Fiery and dramatic. With the sun fighting to preserve every last ray of light.
For me, there's never enough sun. I hate cold and damp. Tell me more about the people. The black savages.
There's some pretty savage whites, too. And some very noble blacks. All the different tribes. The Watusi, the Zulu, Ivambo, and the little Bushman, too. Extraordinary people, all of them.
You love them, don't you?
Yes, I do. There's something about Africa. Makes you part of it. And once you're part of it, never lets you go. Not even when you're away. It's part of me. It's in my heart. It's my land.
One day. I shall go to Africa.
Sontan?
Yes, Michael.
In my country, the Bushmen believe that if you save somebody's life, you've interfered with the gods and with that which was written, fate. Therefore, you have to take their place. The life that you save then becomes your responsibility forever. And belongs to you. So you see, Santen, from now on, I belong to you.
To you, Michael. To you.
Yes. I do.
It all started in France, in the fall of 1917, during the last months of the First World War.
Thank you. looks like.
Much to be done. Love, your wife, Anne. It's a lovely letter, Charles. It should help you get back on your feet quickly. You're awake at last, Captain. How do you feel?
Well, I was always told St. Peter looked after new arrivals. So who are you? A heavenly angel? St. Clair? St. Teresa?
You're being blasphemous instead of grateful. You should see what's left of your aircraft. Major Brochard, do you want to examine the English flyer? He's awake now.
Oh, wait. I'm not English. I'm South African.
Oh, and there's a difference?
Much as between their reign and our sun, manners.
This one looks very much alive and kicking. He can wait. Maybe more wounded should be brought in upon your horse. It brings about miraculous recoveries.
You saved me from the fire. I think I preferred your other uniform. Less spirituality, but definitely more charm.
You need cleaning up, Captain.
Michael. And what's your name, nurse?
Nurse.
Oh!
The Major is right. You're alive and kicking. Far too alive, if you ask me.
No, wait. You saved me. You can't leave me now. Well, I feel awful. I've got these shooting pains in my head. There's a,
something I can't see. My eyes.
I knew it. She was only a vision.
A miracle. The captain can see again.
Tell me something. That nurse friend of yours. What's she like? Well, does she have a boyfriend? Is she married?
You're referring to the daughter of the owner of this chateau. She's not a nurse. She's Comtesse Santaine de Thierry.
Santaine. What an extraordinary name.
Doc, you can open your eyes now. We've landed.
A miracle. That's what I call it. A bloody miracle.
It's me, okay? And this is the German's plane. Now, we're flying along through the clouds. And I don't know he's behind me. And suddenly, as we come out of the clouds, well, there he is, right behind me. So I spin round with the plane, so I'm behind. We're flying like this, and then
bang! What do you know? I'm looking for a dead hero, and I find a living clown.
Captain Courtney's flying adventures have been very useful. You see, we have neither anesthetics nor sedatives. His stories make quite a good substitute for the patients. They're very soothing.
You're very cruel to me. As a punishment, I'm going to introduce you to my notorious friend, who's also my commanding officer. This is Lord Andrew Killingarret and Captain Surgeon Clark. And this is Santaine, Comtesse de Thierry.
Delighted to meet you. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have to prepare his dressing.
Well, what do you think? Remember, I saw her first.
So, that's the way it is.
She's the woman of my dreams, Andrew.
Oh, really? You don't say, laddie. You South Africans are all crazy.
See, it's not just your heart is wounded.
I'm burnt all over, damn you.
Oh. We're just in time. I brought good old Doc
and the medicine.
Good Scotch whiskey. Great stuff to bring you back from the dead. And I got a whole crate full in the sidecar.
Great, you say? Well, I know just the place to put it to good use.
Some respect. There are sick people here.
No, madame. Not exactly sick people. I see here a lot of young people. Well, most of them are missing a piece or two, granted. But they still have a lust for life. Plenty of taste for happiness. Besides, we've only used 2 bottles. And the rest, we leave to you. Scotch whiskey. It's the oldest anesthetic there is.
In any event, madam, we do apologize. Now we'll be off.
Yes, yeah, it's time we go back.
Ah, bye.
See you later.
Bye. Bye.
Now planes, all that filthy noise.
Pretty soon it's curdled milk we'll be getting from the cow.
One of them's in trouble. Something's wrong.
Sotten, wait! Sotten! Soldiers, flyers, drink loose women, and trouble. That's all they're good for. More oil.
What do we have today, Anna?
Celery, Monsieur le Comte.
Rotten apples and celery. That's the diet for a man. What am I supposed to do? Wiggle my ears and whinny?
Things could be worse. We do have some food. And this house is the only one still standing for miles around. You should thank the Lord instead of complaining.
I must admit that the house and the wine cellar have been miraculously spared. It could be the good Lord. On the other hand, it could also be Bacchus.
No, Monsieur le Comte, really, it's too early.
Quite right, Anna. No respectable man should start drinking at this hour of the day. I, on the other hand, have been drinking since quite a respectable hour last night.
to heaven.
The weather has been strange, not like other years at this time. Maybe it's not. We had a bad frost some days back, but the potatoes are safe. Blanche had a cough. It was weak. It is stronger now. We lost two chickens, but your pa got the fox. Pierrot has been helping. He's strong for 14. We hope you'll be back soon.